Hello and welcome. In this video, I will show you how to create a rolling dice in HTML from scratch. I will do this by using the CSS grid and by using some JavaScript. So let's get started. So to get started, I'm going to create an HTML file. I'm going to create a folder for our CSS and a folder for our JavaScript, like so. I'm going to create the styles.css and the main.javascript, and then I'm going to create the template for our HTML file. I'm going to create a link for our CSS. Rel is style sheet, and href is .css styles.css. Then I'm going to create our body. And then beneath our body, I'm going to create a script tag with our JavaScript, like so. And I'm going to close the script tag, like so. I'm going to save this up, and I'm going to open up the page and refresh it. And right now we see nothing, but if we type something in our body, we will see our text being displayed. Okay, so for this dice, I'm going to create a div, like so, and I'm going to add that to our styles. So I'm going to say hashtag dice, and then I'm going to say that I want the background color of white, and I want to target the body because I want to make the body gray. Body background color of RGB. 40, like so, something like this. Then I also want to get this dice a fixed width and height, so I'm going to say width 250 pixels, height 250 pixels. So now we actually see our dice right here. I also want to remove the margin from the body, and I'm also going to add a display of flex, and I'm going to center our dice in the middle of the screen. So I'm going to say display flex, and then align items center, justify content center, and then I'm going to add a height to our page. I'm going to say 100 view height, like so. So as we can see, our dice is now being centered inside of the page. So then I want to create the eyes of the dice. For the eyes, I'm going to use spans, and I will be using 7 spans. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like so, because we have 1, 2, 3 on the left, 1, 2, 3 on the right, 1 in the middle, and the top and the bottom aren't used, I think, because this is 6, we have 4, 3 is diagonal, and then we have 5, yes, okay, so we have 7 eyes in total, and I'm going to give each pen a fixed location. So the first one will be the upper left eye. So I'm going to say upper left, then we will have our middle left, then our bottom left. I'm going to create the center eye, and then everything the same, but then the right, upper right, middle right, and bottom right. Like so. And what I actually want to do is I want to add a class to it. I want to say that this will be upper left, this will be the middle left, bottom left, center, upper right. Copy this. Middle right, like so, and we'll have our bottom right. Okay, so now that we have our classes, I'm going to create the styles for it. So inside the dice, I'm going to target the upper left, and I'm going to say hashtag dice upper left, and then I want to say position of absolute, and then a top of 10 pixels, left of 10 pixels, And then I'm going to say that I want a background color of black, a width of 20 pixels, and a height of 20 pixels, something like this. And then I want it to be relative to the dice. So to the dice, I'm going to say position relative, like so. And then right now we see our eye in the dice. And I think I want to make it a little bit more from the top, 25 maybe. Yes, and then maybe a little bit larger, 50, or that might be too large. And maybe 40. Yes, okay, so this looks good. I only want to add a border radius, so I'm going to say border radius of 50%. Okay, and then I want to do the same for the middle left, the bottom left, center, upper right, middle right, and bottom right. So this will be middle left, and then we will have a top of not 25 pixels but something like 125. And then for the bottom left, I'm going to say bottom. Oh, bottom of 25 pixels. And then this will be bottom left, like so. So I actually want this eye to be centered. And to do that, I'm actually going to divide this cube into a grid. So I'm going to say display grid to our dice. And then I'm going to define some grid sections. So I'm going to say grid and then template areas, like so. And then we can define our areas, which will be the top left, the top right. And I'm actually going to add a dash right here. Then we have the middle left, or yes, I named it middle left. Middle, or this will be center then, middle right, bottom left, bottom right, like so. And then I'm going to have to define the sizes of the areas. So I'm going to get template columns, which will be one of air, and for the rows I'm also going to say one of air each, like so. And now I'm going to apply this to the grid template area. So instead of position absolute and top and left of 25 pixels, I'm going to say grid area, and that will be top left, like so. So that is already working correctly. I want this to be, instead of position absolute and this, I want to say grid area middle left. Okay. So that's not actually what I'm trying to achieve, but let's go with it for now. Grid area of bottom left, like so. Okay, so first thing I'm noticing is that they are horizontally stacked and not vertically. Okay, so the layout I'm actually trying to achieve has to be done by removing the double quotes right here. So if I remove those, it will see that it is fitting inside of the grid. And how I found this out was, if I put this back and I'm going to inspect this element, I will see in the element inspection tool that I have an invalid property, and that is because I added the double quotes. So for example, on this one it does recognize it. So that's how I knew that we did something wrong, and now that we have fixed it, it is displaying correctly. I'm now going to look at how much space we have in our span, and if I say now left 50%, nothing happens. So if I say width of 100%, it will fill to its grid. So that's actually looking okay-ish, I think. But we do also want to have a little bit of margin on each eye. So right now they are taking up every little bit of space. So yeah, I'm going to just keep it like that for now, I think. So I'm going to say width of 100% and a height of 100%, and then we can deal with the margin later, like so. I'm going to create the center, so I'm going to copy over this. I'm going to say dot center. and the grid area will be center, like so. And then we're going to create the top right, middle right, and bottom right. Top right, or how do they call it? Upper right. So this will also be upper right. And I'm afraid, yes, I called this top right and top left. Well, that's okay. We can name our styles upper right, and then we can just call the grid area top right. Then we have middle right, and then bottom right, grid area is also bottom right. Okay, so if I save this up, we'll see all our eyes being displayed, but I actually want to remove them a little bit from the border. So I think by applying a little bit of margin to it, it just offsets it. So that's not good. Padding maybe. That's far too much. That's also not really the solution. So I think I'm going to create a div for this section, and inside the div I'm going to create a span. So I think that's the most appropriate solution, because then we can wrap our span inside of the actual column and row. So I'm just going to copy over this really quick. Now I'm going to call this bottom left, middle left, right here. Right here we have center. Oh, upper right, this will be middle, and then bottom right. Okay, so I now copied over every span. I put it inside of a div, like so. And I put the class on the div itself. So actually nothing is changing right now. What I want to do right now is I want to add the class of eye to the span. And what this will do, I will show you in a second. So right now we have the containers for our eyes, which will be the divs. And then we have the eyes inside of the div. So what I'm actually trying to achieve is I'm going to say that we don't have a background color and a border radius. But I'm going to say that we have a display of flex inside of here. And that this one will have a width of 50 pixels, height of 50 pixels, and a background color of black, like so. And here I can say just for content center and align items center. Like so. Yes. And then I can say right here border radius 50%. Okay, so this is exactly what I want. Now it is relative to its own cell, and we can then define inside of the cell our span. So that's what I'm going to add. I'm going to create a upper class right here, which will be eye container. So every eye container will share the same code, so we don't have to duplicate it in every separate class. Okay, so I'm going to add a class at the bottom right here. Go to iContainer, and that is inside of our dice. And then I'm going to say that we have a display of flex inside of that, justify content center and align item center. And then I can remove the width from every dice. So I can even remove the background color and the border radius. And I'm actually going to copy over the background color and border radius. So now our dice only contains the grid areas, which is okay, I think. So now it looks like this. And what I want to do then is I want to say to the eye. So inside our dice we have an eye container, and inside the eye container we have an eye. And in our eye, I will want a border radius of 50%, background color black. And then I want to say that we have a width of 100% and a height of 100%. Or, wait, I meant, sorry, 50 pixels and 50 pixels. Yes. Okay, great. So this is looking really good. I'm going to increase it a little bit, like so. Okay, wait, that's too much. 60. Yes. Okay, awesome. So right now we have our state of the dice, in which we have 7 eyes, which will never happen. So now I'm going to create the separate states. And to do so, I'm going to add classes to the eyes. So each eye will be used by a number. So for example, the top left will be used when a 6 is being displayed, when a 3 is being displayed, when a 4 is being displayed, and a 5, and also when a 2 is being displayed. So I'm going to add classes to the eyes, and I'm going to say i2, i3, i4, i5, and i6. This middle eye will be displayed when we have a, let's see, not a 3, not a 4, not a 5, only when a 6 is being displayed. So I'm going to say i6. The bottom left will be displayed when we have an i2 nut, 3 nut, 4, i4, and i5, and an i6. Then we have the center eye, which will be displayed when we have an i1, an i2, or no, 2 nut, i3, i5, and that was it. Then we have the upper right, which will be displayed when we have another 2, 3, no, 4, i4, i5, and i6. This one will be displayed when we have an i6 only. And this one will be displayed when we have i4, i5, i6, and also an i2 and 3, I think. So this is the same as the first one, I think. Yes. Okay, so now we have added every class. For when the dice needs to show. And to make the dice actually show, I'm going to use a little bit of JavaScript. So I'm going to create a button right here, and the button will have an ID of roll, and I'm going to say roll the dice. Yes, and then I don't really like the looks of it, but for now it is fine. So I'm just going to say that when we click on this, I will execute the function roll the dice, like so. And then I'm going to name this function inside of a main.js. I'm going to say function roll the dice. And I'm going to put all log. I want to roll the dice. Okay. So if I open up console and press on the button, I can see that it is rolling the dice. And then I want to have a random number between 1 and 6. So I'm going to say const number equals math.random, and then I want to do it times 6. And if I then console.log the number, I will get a number between 1 and 6, but then I want it to be an integer. So I'm going to say math.floor, I think. So this will round the number down. Then we have a 1, 1, 0, 2, 1, 1, 2, 4, 1, 5. Okay, so I actually need to add 1, so it's between 0 and 5, or between 0, between minus 1 and 6 right now, and that's not what I want. So I'm going to say times 6 plus 1, like so. And then we have the 3, 2, 5, 6, I see a 1, yes. Okay, so I see every number right now. And then I want to display the correct number of eyes when we have that amount of numbers. So I'm going to say I'm going to write a switch statement. So switch, and I'm going to use a number. I'm going to say case, and then I want to say 1. And I think it's like this. No, case 1, like so. And then I'm going to say console.log we true 1. And then if I throw 1, it will go, yes, okay, it will go and execute that case. So in a switch, we evaluate the number, and if it finds this case, it will execute this, and we will break out of it. I will do the same for the 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6. We true 2. 3, 4. I could also use an if else statement, but then it will be if it is 1, else if it is 2, else if it is 3, else if it is 4. So instead of doing that, I want to do it more gracefully by using a switch statement. So I think that suits this situation better. Okay, so now we are inside of a switch statement, And when we throw one, I actually only want to display all the dices which have I1 on them. So how I'm going to do this is I'm going to add a new class to our eyes, and that will be iVisible. So it will look like this, iVisible. And then I'm going to say in our styles.css that by default our eye will have an opacity of 0. So when we refresh the page, we won't see any eyes. And that's when we have a visible eye, iContainer iVisible, we will have an opacity of 1. So that is the eye we want to see. So this is what the iVisible function will do. And then I'm going to actually remove it, or I'm going to, yes, remove it from here. And then I want to say when we roll 1, we want to add the iVisible to every eye that has the I1 class. So I'm going to create a new function, toggle I, and then I want to say const or just number, and I'm going to say toggle dice, and here I'm going to say we threw 1, toggle dice with the number. So I'm actually going to pass in a number, and then I can say right here that we want to target all the let's see, spans with the I and then the number. So I'm going to say const eyes equals, or wait, I elements equals document get elements by elements by class name, and then it will be I dash and then our class name. And I'm actually going to use a string template which will allow me to do this. I can use a variable instead of the string. So I dash number, and then I'm going to just console.log the eyes. So right now, if I roll a 1, let's see, 5, 6, 3, 2, yes, okay, we roll a 1, we will see that we have the element which has the class on it. So that's really good. I then want to add a new class to the element. So I can say for that I is 0, I smaller than I elements dot length, and then I can say I elements I dot class list dot add, and then I want to say I visible, and then if I roll a 1 right now, I will see the 1 getting visible, I think. Yes, okay, so we threw a 1 and we see the 1 getting visible. But then when we throw another number, I actually want the 1 to become invisible again. So in this toggle function, I'm actually going to get every I element, and then I want to remove the I visible class from that one. And then I want the element that we are throwing, and I want to add the I visible element to that one. So instead of just getting the I element that we are throwing, I'm just going to say that we want all the I elements. So I'm going to say I think. So every I element has in class I. Yes, it's true. So get elements by class name I. And if I just log this, we will hopefully see every I element in the console. Okay, so we see nothing. So that's not really good. So the reason we see nothing is because we only have the function on the 1, like so. So if we throw a 1, we will see all our eyes appearing. So it is actually working. And then I want to say that we want the throwing element. So then I want to only display the eye element which we are throwing. So I'm going to loop through the array of eye elements, and I'm actually going to use the array that we have already created. And then I want to say if eye elements I dot class list dot contains, and then we want to say if it contains the class that we are targeting, this, which will be I dash, and then I'm going to use the literal template again, which will be number. So if the I is in this case the 1, so that only will be this element, then we want to display it. So I'm going to say I elements I class list dot add. And then I'm going to say, what was it again? I visible, I think. Yes. And else, if we are not targeting that eye, I'm going to say that it is not visible. So I'm going to remove this class, like so. And then I want to execute this function on every time that we throw. So instead of doing this, I actually can say that we want to remove the switch case where we worked really hard on, and I can just say toggle dice number, because this function will take care of everything. Because if, for example, we throw a 1, we execute the function, we get every eye element, then we make the 1 visible and the rest invisible. If we throw a 2, we will make the 2 visible and the rest invisible. So we don't need the switch case anymore. And right now, if we throw a dice, it's 6, 4, 4, 3, 4, 1. And I'm just going to add the number right here, so you can see what's actually happening. 3, 3, 5, 4, 6, 1, 3, maybe 2. Yes, true. Okay, so nice. We actually have our dice working. I think it's really cool how it works out, and I'm really happy with how it looks right now. But I actually want to make a little special effect to it, and the special effect will be that when we click roll the dice, it will actually start spinning, and then when it's finished spinning, it will give us a number. So I don't actually know how to apply it yet, but I think I'm going to say that we want a for loop. So I want to, run the dice maybe 10 times. I plus plus, and then each time I want to re-roll the number. So instead of making a const, I'm going to say let, and I'm going to create a function for it. Function roll dice, and I'm going to return this. So right now this is a really simple function, but if we were to have a complicated function, it is nice to have a separate function for it. And I'm going to rename this. I'm going to name this throw dice and this roll dice. So right here we're going to say throw dice, and there it is. Maybe not the best naming convention, but well, you can change it if you want. And then I can say number equals and then roll dice, and I'm going to do the same above here. So I'm going to say let number equals roll dice, and then I want to actually remove this one because we are just re-rolling it. Oh no, I do want to add it here because we have to initiate the variable. And then after each roll, I want to console.log the value. So I want to say what our number is, initial number, and this will be number, and then I'm going to say we re-rolled, and then this. Okay, so right now we should see, yes, we have an initial number of 3 and we re-rolled it 10 times, and as you can see we came across multiple numbers. But it is happening really fast, and I actually want to have a little bit of time between those numbers. So I think we can fix this with a small timeout. So I'm going to implement a timeout with a promise function. I'm going to say function sleep, and I will say that we want a time, which will be in milliseconds. And I'm going to say return new promise, and then we will use a resolve, which will be applied when we have waited our timeout. So when a timeout has been executed, it will resolve this promise, and the timeout will take the amount of milliseconds that we have specified, like so. So if I say right here sleep, and then I'm going to say 100 milliseconds, it will execute this function, and it will create a promise which will resolve after 100 seconds, after 100 milliseconds, so then we can continue with the function. But right now nothing will happen, and that is because we aren't waiting for our sleep. So I'm going to have to say await, and since we're using await, it will be an async function. So if I roll the dice right now, we can see that we have a little bit of time between each dice. So what I want to do now is I want to display the dice when we are rolling it, so we actually see the dice being re-rolled. So I'm going to say toggle dice and then put it after the number right here. And if I save this up and refresh the page and toggle the dice, we will see our dice rolling a little bit. So that looks really cool, I think. And I actually want to make it a little bit faster, 50 milliseconds. Yes, and then maybe roll it like 25 times or something. Yeah, okay, that looks really cool. And then I can remove the console.log like so. And let's see, do I have any other elements which we don't need? We don't want the initial number. So I think this is it for now. I might want to add a little paragraph to it, which will say what number we have thrown. So this will be the dice number, and that will remain nothing. And then once we have thrown our dice, we can say that we want to document.getElementById, and that will be dice number. I'm going to say inner HTML, and then I want to make it equal to we rolled, and then the number, which will be number. Congratulations, like so. I'm going to save this up, and then when we roll something, we can see the text being displayed with the number we have rolled. And then maybe say if we if number smaller than 6, then we want to display this, and else we want to display maybe something else. We want to say, let's see, we rolled 6. You have won the die, or you are the dice master. Yes. Okay, so if we roll the dice, we will see that we rolled 5, 1, 6. Yeah, we rolled 6. You are the dice master. Okay, so right now we have created a dice which you can roll. You will see a little animation, and we'll see the text with what number we rolled. You can create really cool things with this. I hope you have enjoyed it and that you could follow along. It is completely with JavaScript, HTML and CSS, so it's really easy to recreate. So I want to thank you for watching, and I hope I see you next time. Bye.